basically, I started playing cricket in primary school, then ended up going to SMUC, where rugby was the only sport you could play. That's how I started playing. S1, baptism of fire, you're playing against S2, S3, S4, S5. Yeah, so that's where I started from. I've always played 10, through high school, through all my life, most of it, and then they slowly started pushing me out when I got taller and a bit fatter. Well, twofold, of course, a team would want someone who can play anywhere, obviously. You provide different things in each of those positions, because if you can play 10 and then you can play on the wing, you're 10 playing on the wing, so you offer a lot on the wing. But then again, they will also want that specialist who can do a lot more in that position. So it's twofold. You can't have your cake and eat it. So I had a tough time in Pirates. You know, everyone in their career, no one is going to be 100%. Even Federer has his bad times. He's number one. Carter had his bad times, he went to the World Cup. So I'm not comparing myself to those people, but I can't make myself bigger than those people, because either I'm an amateur. So I had a slump, and there was someone coming up and they picked him, and so, you know, confidence dies away. The press also starts giving you some stick. So I think I wasn't mentally ready for that deep. If I'd been mentally prepared, I would have risen above it much earlier, but yeah, I wasn't mentally prepared. I went to the UK, did some studying, did some playing. Actually, I think that's where I revived my playing career, because I went there and I was playing. They pushed me to 12. The 10 and I it was a very good partnership, actually. I wish he could somehow, I'll send him this video and he'll have a look at it, because I enjoyed a good playing partnership. I learned a lot, different playing style there, a lot more teaching than we do here. Yeah, overall, I learned a lot, and I hope some of those boys can come down here and you see what I was working with. Your perception and my perception of what I'm doing are two different things, because when I'm on the pitch, I think I'm doing what a 12 should do. But then maybe I'm adding in aspects to things I learned before. So, because when you go on that pitch, it's a whole different scenario. You can't be like, oh, now I will carry the ball like a 12. No, or now I'll kick like a 10. No. So you play what's in front of you, and if what I'm doing looks good, then thank you very much. Several people have told me that I should go train, whether I was cold or not, whatever has happened. I've had my history with rugby. Right now, if I have time, I do not want to be, I don't like giving a sport or people 50% of my time. So like, even with Kobs, they know I have a very tight working schedule. So when they accord me the leverage to go to the gym at my time to train as much as I can during my own time. But those are pleasures that you can't enjoy with the national team. You have to be committed, because you're coming up against people who are training day in, day out. So I would understand if I was picked. I'm going to try and train, which understandable, but I do not see myself being picked, because the way my schedule is set up right now, it's very tough for me to make that team. I was dreaming about that in Pirates, huh? So it would have been, obviously it would have been good to win that with my friends Eric and Mawanda and the likes, but well, I've gotten a chance here. The guys I'm playing with, I think it's the youngest squad in the league. I stand to be corrected, and I am happy. If we go unbeaten, it will even make it more pleasurable. First, actually, my debut was against Heathens. I came on, I think, at 15 in Uganda Cup semi-final. I don't know, I forgot which year, but I came on at 15, played 15 minutes or so, and I didn't play the final. The final was against Pirates, which they won. So that was my first trophy with Kobs, but winning at Heathens is always, always a pleasure. I cannot say that in any other way. Always a pleasure. I've been putting in some time trying to give back to rugby. So I've refed a few games, I've coached a few games, so I am praying I can push myself more in the refereeing career, but the coaching looks a bit more attractive, so I might be doing more coaching than